Haiti should challenge the devil to a fiddle contest.
Oh, my God. But they don't have Charlie Daniels.
We have Charlie Daniels. Maybe instead of sending $100 million, we send Charlie Daniels down there to battle the fucking devil.
It's Georgia. The devil went down to Haiti? Doesn't sound right.
Him was looking for a soul to steal.
Does Charlie Daniels play a mean fiddle?
I know.
Anyone else sick of that fucking spot?
Does Charlie Daniels play a mean fiddle?
Yeah, there he goes.
Anyone? Woo-hoo. I'm the only one.
I have not heard that.
Geico.
Thank you, Anthony.
Oh, really?
You haven't seen that commercial probably 100 times?
I block out Geico commercials.
Does Charlie Daniels play a mean fiddle?
Yeah.
What's the new one they're doing?
Elmer Fudd.
Oh, the Elmer Fudd thing.
Yeah.
Actually, the Elmer Fudd is pretty funny. Trying to make Elmer Fudd speak properly.
The first time. But they, like, just pound those commercials.
Yeah. Boy, let me tell you what. Come on, turn us up. We're trying to help Haiti. This is what we're doing today.
This will get him out of trouble.
That's right. This is how you deal with the devil.
You play pretty good fiddle, boy, but give the devil his due.
Ah.
I bet a fiddle of gold against your soul because I think I'm better
than you. Oh, well, get the French out.
It might be a sin, but I'll take your bet.
Old Charlie Daniels is.
I'm the best as ever been. Johnny, rosin up your bow and
yeah.
Play your fiddle hard. Cause hell's broke loose in Georgia and the devil deals a card.
Oh, where's the parody that gets people fired?
Get your soul. Who's willing to admit they want to hear this whole song this morning?
I love this song. It's on my iPod.
You know what? This, if you were a true Charlie Daniels fan,
right.
Back in the late 70s, you didn't like this song, and you called people that liked it posers.
Posers?
Yeah. Because, like, you were into the deep tracks of Charlie Daniels, and this was their hit. It's like Grateful Dead people and, you know, one of their hits.
It's
like saying you only like...
The Grateful Dead analogy is basically, they call it beginner dead. Like, real deadheads call, like, the poppy dead songs beginner dead.
If you like Touch of Grey... You are not a dead fan, right?
Yeah.
Come on. Yeah?
Who's gonna... Who's grateful to...
I didn't think I'd say anything. Said,
you're pretty good, old son.
But
sit down in that
chair
right there and let me show you
how to do it. Who's grateful to be dead?
All right, we don't have to listen to Charlie Daniels.
Hey, we definitely went to Georgia to take a bus. We have a good car or something.
Can I hear that Geico guy?
Does Charlie Daniels play a mean fiddle?
I want to know exactly what he says.
Switching to Geico really save you 15% or more on car insurance?
Car insurance.
Does Charlie Daniels play a mean fiddle?
There's an old Charlie Daniels. He can still fucking fiddle.
He is a fiddling old bag of shit, isn't he?
Well, you can tell when he walks away, he's like puffing and puffing.
Hip replacement surgery.
Like, look at when he walks, he's limping like crazy.
Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
He tried that 400 times. No, we have to get the gecko next to your boot, do you? The pretty Australian gecko.
It's a pretty good campaign by Geico, but the problem is they bought way too many ads.
Yeah.
So you see these too many times, I guess. A little acknowledgement here. Jimmy, you asshole. This is Eric in Farmington, New Hampshire.
You could stop it right there.
I am now cleaning coffee off my desk. He's a fiddling old bag of shit, isn't he? Coffee everywhere.
That was me.
In capital letters with an exclamation point.
Boring.
Play a good fiddle, do you?
Not a fan of Charlie Daniels, are you?
No. My mother never liked him. She said that he was kind of southern, and they don't respect that women. My mother's a saint.
What was the second most popular Charlie Daniels song? Anthony was the big Charlie Daniels fan.
It's another.
What's the number two song by Charlie Daniels?
Line them up and shoot. It's a Simple Man is a big song by him too.
Simple Man was very big, but that was a slower kind of ballady thing.
That's not the same Simple Man as Skinner, right? Okay, because I don't know.
No,
I'm not. I don't have much knowledge on this Charlie Daniels guy.
Let me.
I just gave you all of mine.
I Need to Run. Long Hair Country Boy was a big one. South's Gonna Do It Again was a biggie.
I would go with South's Gonna Do It Again, right, Ant?
Yeah, South's Gonna Do It Again.
Do what?
Is a big one.
What are they gonna do again?
Rise up and put
rise
Negroes
up.
In chains.
Exactly.
That's basically what he's saying.
That's pretty much it.
doing? I like the South.
What are you doing?
I like the South, but can we stop with Dixieland?
Come on.
You're not a fan of Dixieland.
How can you be? Look, it's not about being politically correct.
What's wrong with Dixieland?
Because it wasn't just a theory or a thought. They just kind of enslaved blacks and made them fucking do work for free.
You know what? That's part of what the South is about.
At one point, yes.
I understand that. But there is also a pride in what their beliefs were, and a lot of people like having that pride through the flag, the Confederate flag.
What beliefs did that cover?
Just that they fought and sacrificed for their beliefs, which was, we're not going to kowtow to the North.
We're not going
to
free the Nigs. That was their beliefs.
Civil War. It was more than just slavery. It was pretty much
In the end, that's what it comes down to.
The North was getting very industrialized, and the South was being pretty much kept out of it. There was a disparity going on between the North and South. The North was running the government and pretty much cutting off the South, and they got, you know, a little pissed. Slavery thing, yeah, that was part of it.
Big one.
But it wasn't...
That's a big... All their labor, or a lot of their labor, was done by slave... I mean, it's free labor. To give that up, it's almost like if this company all of a sudden had to pay this show what it was worth.
Well, a lot of the thinking behind the reason that Lincoln freed the slaves was to cripple the South, because they had slaves working the South, and it allowed the young men of the South to fight in the war. And they decided, look, if we take away their labor, their boys are going to have to work, or they're not going to have any materials to make a war with us.
It'll crush them if you take away.
So that's what it was. It wasn't this.
It wasn't this big
noble Lincoln. Lincoln's got some very some quotes that are very pro-slavery and very anti-black, and treat blacks like in some of his quotes that they weren't human.
Can I say though? Why would if it was during the war? Why would Lincoln freeing the slaves mean anything if they were controlled by the South and they were in a war? It's almost like, why would the warring sides, why would they respect Lincoln's decision?
Oh, exactly. Yeah, some of them didn't.
Why would any of them if they were in a war?
Some of them did. Especially once they were losing the war.
I just don't. This is where my knowledge of American history is not.
Yeah, that's true. I make a good point. It's like, oh, fuck you. I'm going to keep my slaves. And some of them did say that and kind of got their asses handed to them. And some of the blacks found out and burnt down plantations.
They weren't happy.
No.
Or what? Okay.
Yeah, I didn't realize you were going to go so deep with your Dixieland. I just, like, you know, you hate Dixieland.
I don't hate it. I just
that whole Dixieland fucking symbolism.
I don't hate the South at all. I'm not
too many brass instruments for me.
I just don't like the fact that it's like sometimes, like, let it go.
All right.
We're going to do it again. Do what?
South's going to do it again.
You're not.
Oh, we're still waiting. That song's about 30-some-odd years old. They're going to do it again.
And there's a line in there that goes something like, you know, proud to be a rebel because the South's going to do it again. He's a rebel.
Are you?
Yeah. Yeah, he's a rebel.
Johnny Reb.
It's not.
He's a rebel. Look
tucks in his flannel shirts with his big stomach.
He's a rebel, though. Look at him. And everyone wants to talk about the legend of Woolly Swamp.
I don't know who Woolly Swamp is.
Oh, God.
Is.
That's going a little deep.
That's a deep track from Charlie Daniels, the legend of Woolly Swamp.
You know, I'm just looking at what Danny's popping up, some Lincoln quotes, and you know one has to be anti-black if it's on the Stormfront website.
What'd he say?
Stormfront.
You're the only one in the room that knows that.
What, Stormfront?
I would have thought it was a Weather Channel site.
I love how you assume we all go to the same place as you do.
Tell
me what Stormfront is.
Stormfront's a white supremacist, separatist site.
All right.
Or, as it's also known, the Kumia homepage.
Would you like to make this your homepage?
Yeah.
Oh, damn.
But you said
to bump nmania.com.
You said it like you were referencing Google, though. That's the problem I had. I'm like, yeah, Stormfront, of course. Stupid man.